Ambushed at the ATM, a husband and father shot and killed today in the middle of the day just doing his job. He was working on the cash machine when he was attacked.
My name is Lynn Muscarella. For about 7 years, we have been going to Home Depot and saying, wouldn't that be nice, and wouldn't this be nice, and we could do this here, and we could do that there. Well, the day that it occurred, when I came home, there were people already in my house. It was a little embarrassing because I had stuff everywhere, because we were really in the middle of this project, and so they're all just kind of, you know, packed in like sardines, standing around, and I just looked up and I said, oh, we have so much to do. How am I going to do this? And so Natalie said, well, your church wants to do this for you. And I was so relieved because it's a huge project, and I learned a lot, but cutting out walls and all that other stuff, I really didn't know how to do. So I didn't know how I was going to do this by myself. And then it grew exponentially from there. Then it was, you know, there's someone that would like to help you out with your roof. And I looked at my roof, yeah, I guess I need a little help with that. Then as time passed and I was by myself, I never had to do things by, you know, married for 27 years. So for 27 years, I had someone to consult on these things or to do. And my husband really could do everything. So I realized I am really by myself now. How am I gonna get all this done?
I love how in the Bible that Jesus says that they'll know you are my disciples by your love for one another. Because the love of God is so authentic, and it's without pretense, and it's without asking for anything in return through this random act of kindness, this random act of generosity, that I know that if Jesus were walking the earth right now, he would be at that work site with his sleeves rolled up, with every resource in his tool belt, and he would be getting dirty with us, asking for nothing in return, asking for nothing except that his name be known.
And I said to Joe, I said, listen, it's not a large house. This is the product I need. I'm going to provide all the labor. Would you be willing to provide the material, or your company be willing to provide the material? Joe said, Tom, you know, this is a multinational company, and we get requests for this all the time. It's not like you're dealing with a local supplier, I don't think, but I said, well, just try. Just run it up the ladder. And surprisingly, about 2 weeks later, he called and said, yep, we're going to do it. I don't know how we got this through, but talk to the local manager. He talked to his boss. He talked to his boss, and they agreed to do it, and the rest was history. About a week or two after that, we were putting on a new roof for Lynn. It really just builds your faith to see God at work in so many aspects.
People were donating thousands of dollars worth of time and resources and energy. Neighbors who didn't even know this family were coming down and helping. I mean, it was just incredible.
Just the love, the outpouring, that, you know, love is an action verb. It's an action word. And their people just took their time, took their resources, and rallied around this family through this tragedy. And I know the net good that's will come from this, despite all the pain and suffering, is going to go way beyond this.